Welcome to rycook.com. In this video, we'll discuss about Confluence automations, which will help us streamline our wiki pages or document repository of any enterprise very streamlined. So here, we'll walk you through how we can generate automations on different aspects which is required at the time of document management. Whenever you navigate it to your Confluence pages, you will see this screen available. To get the automation rule, you have to navigate it to your space and simply select on your space settings. So here you can see space settings available. From this, you will find it out automations. Normally, this is a new feature launched in Confluence. If you won't see, maybe you can register with your administrator. So it's very normal for the user who will create rules within Confluence to automate this stuff. Now, if you want to learn Jira and Confluence together, you can watch my previous content. I will include the playlist in description tab so that it will be easy for you to refer. Now, let's get started with Confluence automations. For creating a rule, simply click on rules, and from here, this will navigate into the page where you will see all the rules are available in the screen. Now, I will disable some of the rules because when we are using these rules on a regular basis, maybe we will exhaust our limit. So if you will exhaust your automation rule, you have to request with your again admin. Now, for creating a new rule, we have to just click on rule, and from there we can build our automations. So let's get understand what's the use case for today's automations. Let's say we are working on any Jira issues, and if we have the page which is available on Confluence, and if someone is moving that page into other repository, in that case Jira issue will be created. So that's the use case. Whenever any user will move the pages, that time it will auto log ticket in Jira, and we will have this ticket available till the time we will not get proper resolution. So here I'll just click on create trigger, and this will add move page move. So here we'll select whenever the page will be moved. So click on save. After that, I will add actions. So once the page will be moved, I want to create a ticket. So here we will first connect with our Jira instance, and from there we will be able to create a ticket. So in this ticket, I will select case right within my project. This ticket will be created, and issue type I want log as a task. So this task is generally for the user or the ticket administrator to see why this ticket will be created. If you want, you can set any other fields as well. However, I just wanted to move with the simple title. So here I will specify in the summary, I will specify page.title. So for writing this, I will keep this page as a dynamic. So this is the command where we can use it within double parenthesis page.title, and this title will be highlighted within our ticket. After that, I want to specify the descriptions. So whenever we are adding the descriptions, make sure to add the dynamic description so that whenever ticket administrator is watching that ticket, should have the all those informations present within his screen. So here I will just add this is a new ticket. And after that, I want to add all those details and find all the details below. Now this is done. After that, I will specify the space name. For specifying the space name, we have to just add space name in double parenthesis. Now this is done. After that, I want to add URL. So here will also include page URL, page.url. And next options, I want to add page title as well. So here we'll add page title. Page.title. Let's close this, keep in lowercase so that we'll get the result. And thanks. Created by automation rule. That's it. We'll click on save and this will ask me to enter for name. So here issue created, I will specify issue created and this will be available for all. So maybe I will keep it private for me because this one I will use it for myself. Now this automation rule will be available. Here you can see this is the rule created in this page. Now let me move any of this page into other. So here I want to move this page into Amazon process flow. Now this is done. Let me navigate it to Jira and see, is it really created a ticket for me? Here I will go to my Jira instance. Search for my projects and after that I will get this information. So this is my project. I wanted to see all my issues. Maybe I will check out backlogs or directly search from here. Now here, let me refresh this. Might be this one. Yeah, you can see this issue has been created by today itself and you can see this is unassigned and exactly what text we have added is available here with the link and after that signature. So this is how we can create auto ticket from Confluence without changing or without moving from the Confluence pages, where this will help us to streamline our all those activities which our team is using on a regular basis. This might be a very good example when we have 100 or millions of pages which is available on Confluence Wikipedia and we wanted to streamline our end-to-end process. Rather than involving any manual people, we can directly assign this to our Confluence automation rule and this will create a ticket for me to save thousands of hours for us. So that's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. And trust me, if you wanted to learn about Jira, Confluence, feel free to watch my content from the respective playlist. And I've also created one course on Jira, which might be helpful for you, for those who are learning Jira for Scrum Masters and Project Manager. I will include the course URL in description tag so that will be easy for you to refer from this. Here you can see just rygurukul.profi.com and from there you can find it out my complete course and here you can see this course is available. So Jira for Scrum Master and Project Manager, this is the course name which will help you to learn quickly Jira. So that's all for today's. We'll see you in next part of the video. Thank you.